All modern StyleShoots machines follow a really simple file naming convention, and if you understand it and know what each part is, it's easy to find your files and use them in your content. They'll all have a product name part, which is the product name you started, inputted when you started the session. There will be a framing component. There will be a part telling you which file preset you used. And then finally, there will be a number counter. So for instance, if there are duplicate files, you'll see 1, 2, 3. And at the end, you'll have .mp4, .jpeg, depending on what file extension it is. So all these components together make up the naming of your photos. Now, if it's a video, you won't have the framing component. It will be slightly denser. So say I want to photograph this shoe. I want to take a range of photos, and to change what each file is going to be named, I go into settings and photo presets and file presets. I have a photo preset here called shoe, and in there I have framings. So here I have two already. I have one called side and one called top. I'm going to make a new one called back. I'm going to type that in, back, right, like that. And then I can make sure that my framing is correct. But this is where I change the actual name part. Inside of file presets, I have a photo file preset, which I've called web. And here I can choose both what I see on the iPad, so that's something that's easy for me or my stylist to recognize. And I can also change what the part that goes into the actual file name is called. So here, just for simplicity's sake, call it web as well. And in this case, we've chosen a high-resolution JPEG. So this is going to be a JPEG file when I export this file preset. I also have this other section called file handling. And in here, I can choose whether my folder structure in which my files are going to be placed, if that's going to be based on products or whether it's going to be based on presets. So for instance, if I'm working in a social media team, I might want to have my files organized based on presets. So it's easy to find the files that are for Instagram, for instance, versus the ones for LinkedIn. The final piece of the puzzle is the product name, and I'm gonna enter that right here. So whenever I create a new product or a new outfit, I can either type the product name here, or I can also scan a barcode. So just hold up my barcode, and now this is gonna be the first component of every subsequent photo of this product. So here are the final exported shots, and you can see the product name, the framing, the file name, the number, and the file extension.